three, so we are in Switzerland and not German. I begin 1 minute after 3 o'clock. So, hello, my name is Lothar. I want to tell you something about migration, or issue which was coming up in a concrete feasibility study we made for customer. I tell you later a little bit around. And I want to tell the story how get they me scared. Because they took a theme, security, for a political discussion. For the political discussion, if they should or could migrate to LibreOffice or not. And I will tell you which circumstances around come to this theme and how we tried to solve this issue. And I think it covers all the issues in the discussions for a migration which will be faced when you come to a customer. They put everything in this security queue. So let me put a look on the slides. Fox is a website, a platform we are trying to promote for information, get around, even for other free office products, I think you know. So, first of all, as Carlo mentioned yesterday, there's a methodology for migrations, and to frame or take a part of it where we are going, it was very in front of migration methodology. We were in the feasibility study, which is in the front of every migration or rollout deployment, where we have to define targets, what do you want with the migration, where we have to do an inventory for software and hardware, which applications are integrated with Office, to define migration strategy, what you are doing with the old documents, should they go all to the new document format? Or is there another tool or an automation to calculate total cost of ownership? Is it really for financial benefit for the customer to migrate to LibreOffice? And bring this to the decision maker in the company, which decides, okay, we go to LibreOffice or we go to another office product. So, in this story, we are in the very first part where we do software and hardware inventory. And as you see, next slide, it was not such a big customer, it was 250 clients in a tool manufacturer for automotive industry. What they have done, what they are doing is they do physical tools with which cars are combined, are produced. So it's a manufacturer. So not all of 250 clients are daily office users, but around 100-120 of them, they are doing their work daily with the office suite, and others just for filling in some forms for the personal title department for the administrative department. So we were doing such interviews with different people. We have an interview, and we came in late April, I think. It was mid or late April. Come in and heard something, hey, there's something going on, and I've heard heartbleed for this interview. day, but I was not bringing this together with the migration to LibreOffice. As you know, heartbleed was the leak which was found in the open SSL algorithm made by a German student of Münster in it. It made them sensible for security issues. They were feared about the fact that they could get an open source office suite where such a thing like heartbleed could also be integrated. So this was the main issue and the discussions going around, they took this issue to say that this could not be an office suite which we want in our company, because there could be risks, security risks when we use it, and so on. And it was used by mainly by salespersons, where we have the interviews on that day. And what we later understand was that these discussions came from a very specific point, but this we understand later. They don't tell us this on that day. Since people were scared due to the experience of document issues in Microsoft Office by one big customer, it is a huge German automotive producer, and they give their they have to give their offers for their product in a defined form, in a defined document. And everything in this document is defined. Layouts, the formats, and so on. And they had huge discussions with them to bring it into Microsoft Office. And what they fear was, if they get a new Office suite, they have to discuss this with them again. New discussions, new work to do a new form, and perhaps get out of this idea. This is the favor, fear of a salesperson, if there's something between me and the deal, it must go aside. So this was the real fear, the real issue which was behind, but it was the mid of April and there was heartbleed. So, as everybody should know who do migrations in this area, you have to take care about these fears. Don't say, well, this is not a security issue. Go away, you have this technical problems not in the industry. You have to care about this. So what did you do? First, I go to the IT guy and ask him, hey, we need two more days for the feasibility study. He asked me why, and I said, because we want to go with you in a workshop, which not just 2 days, but probably the workaround was 2 days, and define something, what are the security demands for you to get an office suite, not a Microsoft Office suite, not a LibreOffice, an office suite. What are your security demand on it? And spontaneously, and he agreed and said, okay, I want to do this. And we take the salespersons together, not in a face-to-face interview, but in a group, and ask them to give some inputs for the workshop we later made with other key persons. One of the sales guys was with it. And here is what they formulated as security issues with the Office Suite. First of all, they know, okay, that's a technical issue, so I have to formulate no technical vulnerability. So the real IT security issue, well,
that's a wide range. That's a wide range of issues.
And no risk, no fun. Another answer is coming later, something to do with cranium. Second, functional completeness, even in the future, is the fear or the feeling of trust that I have the right tool even for future demands. Even if I don't know it now that I need a specific function, it will be in even in the future. Someone was informed about intellectual property issues. So when everybody could program in this code, there could be a patent drawing or something else where we get to the court and this is not secure. The fourth one I like, we want not to be Robinson Crusoe. What he meant with Robinson Crusoe was if I go to, if I will explain it in a later slide, if I work with other people, even outside of the company, I want to handle that. So my initial question back to him was, hey, Robinson Crusoe, wasn't he the securest man in the world? The securest man in the world. He didn't agree. The IT leader said, hey, costs and follow-up costs. Costs I can estimate, but what are my follow-up costs? I'm insecure or want to have trustworthy about follow-up costs, zero and so on. And this is a support theme, if I get in trouble, who could help me, and so on. So this was a list, or the main issues of the list, which was made initially on that day where the inventory interviews were originally planned. And we decided that we have to go a little bit more in detail, and we arranged another date for the workshop with five people to go in detail, and we managed that we could have another technical guy with me, and that we could take some issues of that and show them directly what is the answer of LibreOffice for that. Not all of these are technical issues we have seen, so we have discussions, but especially some of it should be shown directly to them that they are secure, that they could have trust in LibreOffice. So, in the real technical security issue, they formulated, well, they could some source code keys. What am I doing with source code keys? But this was not the example which we could give them in the workshop, but I took that because it's very good example of the last weeks, even if it's not a source code leak, but it handles CSV issues, I think. There is a backworded security fix for version 4.2.6. So there was the first version of 4.2.6, and they get a bug fix in it for CSV filters. So we can show LibreOffice community and others, or they are part of the community, are aware of security issues and they are reacting on it. Then they asked about macro viruses and so on. And we showed them the security center of LibreOffice, showed them, hey, look, you have the same security levels with macro handling as in Microsoft Word. Passwords or documents or parts of it. And this was even a funny point because first we discussed, hey, passwords could be cracked and are not safe, are not safe encrypted, and there are going rumors that you can crack Microsoft Word passwords and so on. So, is it a good encryption algorithm in LibreOffice for passwords? And we showed them, even in LibreOffice, there's the same or quite better encryption models with it than they have in their old Microsoft Office version. Okay, we're fine with it. Afterwards, hey, what's when my guy is done who did the password? I want to know the content of the document, and we decide that this is not an issue which is differentiating Microsoft Office, LibreOffice, or another Office suite, but it is an issue. But it is security for them. Another big point was the online update. Every activity going via the internet through someone else giving data or something like this for update for these they know the UI feedback system what they are doing and so on, and they don't know. And we showed in the options that you could say yes or no, and you could give a level of what is going from out of my client to another person. And even we showed them that they can use it for their own. That they can use the online update process in LibreOffice on their own server. That you can link these automatic online update to a source in your environment where you can decide, now I want to update my my version, and they could take it out from there. This was the first time they said, oh, there's more than they have before. Okay. So this question we were here two or three times. Here's another question, what about Microsoft Office and these issues? With these permanent patch demands, what you have to do, what is with the binary document format? You don't know what is in there. With the password algorithm, I have explained which runtimes and DLLs are in the Microsoft Office and which were used. The control, the transparency about the data which is going over the internet, and so on. And this was the first time they get interested in it. There was a little, much more of such issues. I've mentioned feedback crash reports, the registration process when they start to work with it, even the quick starter theme, we showed that they can turn off it. There was the fear what it was that process doing on my computer. So turn it off and we have no problems. Lots of data in my office very smart. This was a functional issue. Because of the architecture of LibreOffice, if one module of LibreOffice breaks, the whole process is crashed. So the other modules are crashed, and you have to do the document recovery process for all kind of modules in LibreOffice. Administrative tasks and so on. And now we are stepping a little bit away from the real technical security issue and coming to the soft parts of it. Just in the duration of the life cycle of a suite. It means that they use Office much longer than one version of Microsoft Office, longer than 5 years. And they want to have this decision the second sustainable. This is an absolute right decision point. And with this question, there was how often have I do I have to have a new training? How often is the UI changing? You know, this is one of the big arguments for LibreOffice. About the duration of the life cycle, is there a sustainable software development process behind LibreOffice? So, are we getting bug fixing and support? How is it organized? Could I see some fault lists and see the process in which the issues are fixed? And we showed them a little bit of the organization of the TDF engineering steering committee, which decides about the release cycle. We showed them that there is a version angle for still and for fresh to get new functions and to be secure with stable versions. And so on, and there are hunting sessions, and so on. And we discussed the theme duration. I often say it's the open source insurance. They asked, okay, if the community is away, what will be with the product? I asked, okay, even if it's not very that Microsoft will go away and don't deploy a new Microsoft computer. But what is if Microsoft says no, we are doing no more Office suites? And this is what I call the open source assurance, and it is shown by LibreOffice. There will be, because of the open source issue, there will be another community or supporter or so on, which take the open source and make it added value for them. And it goes on. So this is an issue which is positive against Microsoft Office. So the question, what about Microsoft? Trusted functional completeness is the question, do I get all modules, functions, interfaces I need in the future? I explained this in the fourth screen. What did we show them? We showed them the modules, we showed them that they get a desktop database for free for all clients, because they have a two version strategy in the company. Some guys have access, they did have access, and some not. And they get a free for all clients, beside the discussion if it is good or not. We showed them that the interface is okay, the UI, that it is similar to that what they know, that there is an pendant to the add-on on the Microsoft Office side with extensions, that there are sources to get extensions for free or for paid license. The only thing that was a little bit problematic, that the take the main client, the example of the main client, that this was not bundled in the LibreOffice suite. But you all know the answer. two different administrative processes to install them. So this was one point we said, okay. In the pure LibreOffice suite, there's no Becker.
Right.
They asked about, for the future, about browser office. We could give them some hints, especially in the get now, you know that there's something going around Android, or other tools which are based on LibreOffice with the same look and feel in rollup.com and so on. And gave them a feeling that there are solutions like Microsoft Office 365. Another weak point was collaboration. Collaboration features. Yes, we discussed a little bit about SharePoint protocol and that LibreOffice is or will be able to take the SharePoint protocol even with other Microsoft Office suites. But if you're honest, you have to say this is 60 to 70% of the functionality which SharePoint is giving the Microsoft Office suite. It's an integration issue. So, even in this point, the question, and what about Microsoft Office? A lot of proprietary issues. Packaging of Microsoft Office in versions, you have different versions. This is the answer to the desktop database. What is about the changes in the VBA object model? You have to migrate, even if you go to another Microsoft Office suite, your macro, your macros, your applications built on the VBA object model, what is with the user interface, ribbons, and so on. You all know these issues. With or without the file menu. Trust in interoperability and compatibility. Well, something out of this slide, you have even heard this all this in the talks yesterday in the professional business talks. I do not want to be Robinson Crusoe. Can I collaborate with external suppliers, customers effectively? It's the issue about document formats, layout fidelity, to see the same in the same layout. Even in the exchange of functionality, what they meant was formulas and macros that we can do both on both sides. And the combination synchronous and asynchronous here. And what we did is that we showed them, there was another part of the story that the managing director was using heavily his tab and ebooks and so on, and he's working with the ebooks format, document format, and we showed him a document with LibreOffice, and he was flashed about this. So we showed them the filters, the in and export filters of LibreOffice, and proved that this is a clear advantage in comparison to Microsoft. Behavior in the product vendor, I don't have to say a lot of it, but this is the part where that's even what Italo mentioned, that you have to tell something about the organization around LibreOffice, the document foundation, how it works, that there are no dependencies to main sponsors, the license issues, that there is a foundation around the TDF, especially for this kind of fears that somebody could take it and take the LibreOffice or the project or the product and bring it to another way to bring up follow-up costs and so on. So the idea was something, some information about TLF and some technical issues, open interfaces and using of open interfaces and formats and the standards. I think this is even worse to compare this with Microsoft. This is a clear advantage of LibreOffice. And so on. My time is over. So,
if you get the job,
sorry,
if you get the job, I can.
So, in summary, there were three clusters of fields which they summarized around the word security, the real technical security issues, security out of the product care, how the product is developed, and some financial security fears, total cost of ownership, which I mentioned in this talk. Not so much. So, security and trustworthiness is present and possible if you use LibreOffice. This is a message you could give. It's no problem to ask for. So, take the fears of the users and give information, information, information. This is the key point in it. But even in such discussions, be honest. If there's something not quite comparable with Microsoft Office, tell it. And you got the trust of the people. And yes, afterwards, they were prepared to get the job. Thank you. Right to buy for the same price and Microsoft. So they get one, they can get